إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا وشفيعنا محمد ابن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين فجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة فمحى الله به الغمة فاللهم اجزه عنا خير الجزاء سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد فيا أحباب رسول الله ويا أتباع رسول الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله فمن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون إن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greeting of Islam, the greeting of أهل الجنة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I bear witness there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. O you believe, fear Allah. Fear Allah and don't die except in the face of Iman. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns from every newly invented matter in the religion of Islam can take us in the wrong path, can end us in hellfire. Wal-iyadu billah. Indeed, the best word is the word of Allah, and the best guiding is the guiding of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah. Thumma alhamdulillahi ala ni'mat al-Iman. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't thank Him enough. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestowed ni'mah upon us. Ni'mat al-Iman. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave us another chance. Another day to worship Him. Another Friday. He gave us the opportunity to come and listen and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness and the mercy. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا. Alhamdulillah, my dearest brothers and respected sisters, our topic today, very important topic, it's about our Iman, it's about our Islam. لا يصح إيمان العبد إلا بها لا تدخل الجنة إلا بها. You will not enter the paradise without this. All your good deeds will not be accepted without this. All your salah and qiyam and zakah and everything you do will not happen and be effective if this is not right. Ala wahwa al-ikhlas fil amal. Ala wahwa al-ikhlas fil amal. What does mean ikhlas fil amal? Sincerity in your deeds, ya ikhwan. It's a very important topic. It's the most important thing in our deen. All the scholars and all the ulama said, Ad-deen huwa al-ikhlas. The deen is the sincerity. Then how can I know, and you know, and all of us know, if I am sincere in my deen and in my deeds? We have to learn. How can I know if I am sincere in my action, in my salah, in my zakah, in my amal? I summarize it in three. First, أولا أن يستوي العمل في السر والعلانية. أن يستوي العمل في السر والعلانية. Meaning that your deed will be exactly the same in a public and by yourself. في السر والعلانية. What you do in the masjid, you do it in the street, you do it at home. Okay? And you know and I know, no more details. أن يستوي العمل في السر والعلانية أمام الناس ومن خلف الناس. In front of people and when you by yourself. Subhanallah, we put the best action and the best behaving in front of people. نهاب الناس. We respect the people so much. ولا نهاب الرحمن. Now, that's the first one. أن يستوي, that their action is equivalent, it's the same in the public and in your behind the people. Second, الإخلاص في العمل, the sincerity in your deeds. يستوي العمل في المدح وفي الذم. أن يستوي العمل في المدح وفي الذم. Meaning that your action and your deed is equivalent. It's the same if people thank you and people don't thank you. If we thank the people who actually act upon this da'wah in the masjid and the cleanliness of the masjid, if I have to thank every single one in his action and his behaving and his giving and his cleanliness, or if I don't thank him. If the family who's cleaning this masjid didn't get the thanks, they continue distributing their time and investing their time without thanking. لا نريد منكم شكرا. We don't want thanking from you. We don't want it from you. We are doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the meaning is, يستوي العمل. If you get the reward from the people and the thanks, or you get the zam. Zam mean, your job is half. You didn't clean very well that last week, by the way. You left some stuff in the side here. Then the humble one says, Alhamdulillah, inshallah, I'm sorry, I was a little bit tired. Inshallah, I'll do better than next week. You see, because I'm not his boss. Maybe I missed the corner. Maybe I was tired a little bit. I will do better. Why? Because I am not waiting for your great. I'm not waiting for your thanks. That means your amal is khalis for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Third, ya ikhwani, and this is the only one who learned that, is the one who dedicate his life and the deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's called, it's called the tranquility, sakina, tranquility, when you action, when you do the deed. Okay, the first one, يستوي العمل في السر والعلانية. The عمل, the deed, will be equivalent when in front of the people and behind the people. The first one. The second one is you also, your deed is the same if you get thanks or you don't get thanks. The third one is the result of your deed. Is the result of your deed. When I do something, come and teach in a class or come and clean the masjid, after I finish this deed, I feel like I am so happy. I feel like I achieved so much. And this happiness called sakina, not a lot of people know it. But when you get to know it, and when you get to feel it, and when you get to taste it, you become addicted to this amal salih. And you will fight if somebody take it away from you. You understand? لا تريد مدحا ولا يهمك ذمه الناس. لا يهمك المدح ولا يهمك الذم. You don't get excited of people thank you, and you don't wait for people to tell you your job is not good. You don't get upset if people complain about your, you know, scale of things, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على المصطفى المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. الحديث الشيق. This topic is very important يا إخوان. Very important because لا يستوي. This is will make it or break it. This, if you don't fix it, you go to hellfire. Now, al-ikhlas, the sincerity. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يقبل من العمل إلا ما كان له خالصة وابتغى به وجه الله. There is no deed you will do if you are not sincere doing it for sake of Allah. وقال رسول الله قال تعالى أنا أغنى الشركاء عن الشرك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like to have a partner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like to have a partner. If you do the action وشاركت به مع الله أحدا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala غني عن عملك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need your action. He leave you with the one that you did it for him. من عمل عملا أشرك فيه مع الله غيره, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ترك. If you do the action and you are expecting the reward from Allah, and also expecting the reward from people and waiting for the people to thank you and recognize you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pull himself from this. Because Allah doesn't love a partner. You understand? Ibn al-Qayyim said something triggered my mind. He said, كم من سكران لم يشرب الخمر كم من سكران لم يشرب الخمر. There's people toxic with alcohol, but they didn't drink alcohol. You understand? There's people are actually intoxicated, but they didn't drink alcohol, but they drink something else, which is the dunya, the loving of the show, the power, the money, the glory, the waiting for things. They are more drunk than the people who took the alcohol. The person who took the alcohol, he might wake up from this, you know, alcohol or drunk status. But the person who actually addicted to this high feeling, he doesn't wake up, ya ikhwan, until he's in the grave. This is how important this is. Some people get high from the glory of thanking and the power and the position. Yes, we left this country behind us, the power and the power of leadership, but we moved it to our masajid. Yes, we left back home the countries that they have the power and the presidential and all these people that they stay in the position of power for years until they die. And we came here for freedom, but we took with us when we were raised back home, we took it to the masajid. Now the power in the masajid, president or vice president or leadership, they want to stay and the presidentially until somebody take them by force. Then we move the country to the masajid. In the masajid lillah. The masajid is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lead by the best of us. Hadith Huzayfa عن الإخلاص. Huzayfa, he had this hadith Qudsi. It's a weak hadith, by the way, but I have to say it. سألت جبريل عن الإخلاص. I asked جبريل عن الإخلاص. I asked جبريل about the sincerity. ما هو الإخلاص؟ فقال سألت الله. Then جبريل asked Allah سبحانه وتعالى رب العزة. فقال الله تعالى الإخلاص هو سر من أسراري أودعتها في قلوب من أحببت من عباد. Okay? Al-Ikhlas is sincerity. When Jibreel was asked by Rasulullah, he said to him, verify for me the ikhlas, the sincerity. Then Jibreel asked Allah, what's the ikhlas? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, al-ikhlas, the sincerity, is a secret from my sickness. I put it in the heart of the believers that I love. When they do the action and they don't want to get the reward from the dunya. And that's why we have a hadith. أول من يصعر بهم النار. The first three people will be the ones that you will be thrown in hellfire before anyone, ya ikhwan, هو قارئ القرآن والمجاهد الذي قتل في شهيد. And the third one, the one who would spend for sake of Allah. Ya Allah, when I heard this hadith, I said, La ilaha illallah. The first one who will be thrown in hellfire is the one who recites Quran. And the second one, the one who fight for sake of Allah and die as a martyr. And the third one who spend in the sake of Allah. This is the three ones that they will be thrown in hellfire. In front of everyone. They were memorizing Quran. They were making tilawah. They were hafiz. They make millions and millions of, you know, followers. Right? And the other one who every fundraising raises his hand, $20,000, $30,000. And the third one who fight for sake of Allah and he died as a martyr. When they come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ لَيَقُولُ عَلَيْكَ قَارِنْ. You read the Quran, yes. You memorize it, yes. But you wonder word from people and say, oh, he memorized Quran so much. His recitation as an angel. وَلَقَدْ قَالُوا. And they said it in the dunya. Go to the hellfire. And the other one who went and fight and was killed in a battle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him, yes, come here. You died as a martyr? Yes. You died with the intention that you want people to say that you are a martyr. And they said it. Go to the hellfire. And the third one, he spent for sake of Allah. He said, okay. They said you are kareem. They said you are generous. Go to the hellfire. You get your reward in the dunya. Ya ikhwan, it's so scary. It's so scary. And it has a very thin line. People said to me, brother, then I'm not going to raise my hand. No. There is a potential. The niyyah, the intention, ya ikhwani, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamaha. Nobody can point fingers. Nobody say that he's a munafiq and he's a riya. No one. You have rules and regulations that you follow. And I will tell you these rules and regulations, three of them. You have to understand the sincerity in three ways. If you learn this knowledge, you will be the doctor for yourself. From the medicine of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طب القلوب ودواؤها وعافية الأبدان وشفاؤها صلوا على الحبيب المصطفى اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليك يا سيدي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله. Three things. First, لابد أن تعلم. You have to understand one thing. معرفة الله. To know Allah. How to know Allah? You know Allah by the asma wa sifat. To know Allah, you have to know the 99 names of Allah and the characteristic of it. Al-awwal, al-akhir, al-zahir, al-batin. Al-malik, al-quddus, al-salam, al-mu'min, al-muhaymin, al-aziz, al-jabbar. You need to know its asma. And the sifat, the characteristic of it. When you know who you worship, you are in the first truth. You are in the right path. Second, معرفة النفس. You have to understand yourself. You have to learn who you are. أنت أنت فاني. أنت ستموت. أنت you. Changing from a habit to another. Changing from desire to another. Today you love money. Tomorrow you love women. The next day you love soccer. You are not a stable. And also you are limited time. And also you are capacity limited. Then you don't know, and Allah knows. The ibadu salihin, they said, I am so happy one time when Allah give me what I ask. But I'm so happy more and more and more when I ask and Allah doesn't give me. Ya ikhwani, what that mean? I'm happy one time when I ask Allah, I raise my hand and I ask Him for something and I get it. Because that's my wish. Because I'm limited. But I am so happy when I ask Allah and He doesn't give me. You know why? Because this is Allah's wish. Then I know that it's better than me, for me. Because I think that this is the best wife for me. And this is the best job for me. And this is the best position for me. The worst position, ya ikhwani, man sakharahu Allah li khidmati al-ibad. This is the hardest job in the earth, ya ikhwan. La tanamu bil-layl. You don't sleep in the night. Because Allah puts you in a position that you are serving for a lot of people. Then people will not be happy with you. People will point finger at you. People will critique you. Days and nights. People waiting for your mistakes. Days and nights. They don't look to themselves. They look to you. And they are looking for the weakness that you have. Then they spread it out and say, you see how weak it is? Many days I wish to isolate myself in a cave. The best time that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had when he was in Ghar Hira was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. مَا بَالُكَ يَا أَبُو بَكْرِ بِثْنَيْنِ ثَالِثُهُمُ اللَّهِ Ya Abu Bakr, fearing what, Ya Abu Bakr? Abu Bakr tell him, Ya Rasulullah, إِذَا نَظَرَ أَحَدُهُمْ تَحْتَ قَدَمَيْهِ لَرَآنَا Ya Rasulullah, if one of them who's coming to kill us looked in his feet, he will see our legs. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a very nice place in earth, he said to him, Ya Abu Bakr, ma baluka bi ithnain, two people, the third of them Allah. Allah ya'mihum, Allah will take their vision, they cannot see. Because I am with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kam ahbabtu an akuna fi ghar hira. I wish I would be in a cave far away from people and they don't see me. But I have a mission. Allah put me in this mission and I will not get out until Allah take me out of it. ما أكثر المصلين ما أكثر الصائمين ما أكثر المعمرين ما أكثر الحجاج. Well, we have a lot of people praying. We have a lot of people making umrah. We have a lot of people giving zakah and sadaqah and charity. And the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the status is the worst. And the music is in the Saudi Arabia right now. رُبَّ صَائِمْ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنَ الصِّيَامِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ وَالْعَطَشِ A person who fasts, only what he gets is the thirsty and the hunger. That's it. وَرُبَّ مُصَلِّ لَا تُرْفَعْ صَلَاتُهَا عَنْ رَأْسِهِ And a person who pray and his salah doesn't go above his head. Then what we need, Ya Rasulullah? Ali ibn al-Hasin. Ali ibn al-Hasin. Ali ibn al-Hussein. Ibn Rasulullah. When he went to Hajj, they tell him, Ya Ali, say to Allah, لَبَّيْكَ حَجَّةً لبيك حجة. Then Ali didn't answer. Ali ibn Hussein. He didn't say anything. Then they said to him, say لبيك حجة. When you go to Hajj, he said لبيك حجة, لبيك عمرة. Right? Oh Allah, I'm coming to the call. I'm almost done. I'm coming for the call. I'm coming to make Hajj. I'm coming to make Umrah. Then they tell Ali ibn Hussein, say لبيك يا الله حجة. He doesn't say it. They said to him, what's wrong with you? He said, I'm so afraid that Allah will not accept it. When I say, لَبَّيْكَ حَجَّةً Allah says, لَا لَبَّيْكَ وَلَا سَعْدَيْكَ No accepting from you the Hajj. And where we see people today, going to Hajj every year, and going to Umrah every year, and they come and say, ha, Allah accept from me. Alhamdulillah, I am Hajj. How guarantee you are of your deed been done and accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last thing, inshallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hadith Ibn Majah, an Thawban, and this will finish with this, inshallah, an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, innahu qal, la'alamanna aqwaman min ummati ya'tuna yawm al-qiyama bihasanati amsali jibalu tuhama bayda, fayaj'alha Allahu azza wa jalla haba'an mansura. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hadith, that people will come, and this is proving that the malaika doesn't even know your intention. The malaika even doesn't know your intention. They don't know. They bring in people in the day of judgment. They bring in people to the day of judgment to the Kaaba, to the Jannah, and they want to enter them to the Jannah because they have so much deeds, good deeds, as the mountain of Tuhama, a big mountain called Tuhama. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said, "Where are you going?" They said, these people, they made so much good deed in this earth. He said, all the good deed is gone. Take them all to the hellfire. Ya Allah. Ya Allah, min hawl hadha al-mawqif. Oh Allah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deed. Khalisatan lillah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to sincerity in our ibadah, in our good deed. When people come to me and tell me, I pray so much nights, I am making Qiyam Layl, I paid $10,000 for the masjid. Ya Akhi, keep it between you and Allah. Ya Akhi, whatever between you and Allah in the night, keep it between you and Allah. Don't show off. Don't ruin your deeds. Don't come and show your muscles. Don't say how many prayers you do. You know, people insisting, hey, listen, I cannot eat today, I'm fasting. Ya Akhi, dinak between you and Allah. Ya Akhi, Monday and Thursday, between you and Allah. The ulama and the scholar and the awliya'illah salihin, when they are in their crowd and they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they put their head like that and they cry. And when people tell them what's going on, they tell, I have zukam. I have a runny nose. And some people, when you enter on them and they read the Quran, they put a cover in their Quran, then they don't see them. And another people, they escape out of the bed in the night. They stay up till their wives sleep and their kids, and then they go in their toes when everybody's sleeping in the house. And they go to cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they tell them how weak they are and how they don't deserve the ni'mah that they have and how they didn't work so much to thanking Allah. Allahumma inni asaytuk. لست هانة بك ولا بقدرتك ولكني عبدك الضعيف الخطاء ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت إني داع فأمنه. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك الله لنا فيما أعطيت. اللهم اصرف عنا شر ما قضيت. اللهم تقبل أعمالنا كلها خالصة لك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الخير كله ونعوذ بك من الشر كله. اللهم إنا نسألك بكل ما سأل به عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعبادك الصالحين، ونعوذ بك بكل ما استعاذ به نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعبادك الصالحين. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى وكل ما يقرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار، ونعوذ بك من النار وكل ما يقرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم لا تفتننا في ديننا، اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكثر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا للنار مصيرنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احينا على الإسلام وأمتنا على الإسلام، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.